Boxing has often been described as one of the most difficult sports in the world due to the grueling nature of preparing for a contest and the brutal reality of engaging in a fight itself, with only the elite and most brave athletes in the world willing to step inside the ring.
We decided to put that theory to the test by putting me, a raw boxing novice, in with a professional fighter to see just how demanding the sport can really be. But first, we need a trainer.
We scoured the country for days on end looking for the best trainer possible. Would Ben Davison come to the rescue? Maybe Tony Sims could lend a helping hand. Perhaps Dominic Ingle would answer our call of desperation. Unfortunately, none of that happened, so we went with the next best thing, Keith.
Hi, I'm Keith.
So Keith, tell me, what do you think makes boxing such a difficult sport?
It's probably the one-on-one. It's just you and your opponent, whereas most other sports, you've got 9, 7 or 8 other players with you, you know, football, hockey or whatever, so...
And do you think more people would like boxing if they went more down the WWE route with people throwing chairs and jumping off cages?
No, I don't think so. Not at all. Not at all. I don't think that would change
people's perception of it. You're not an advocate for that? You're not an advocate for that?
No, not really. No, I'm not really for that white collar boxing. It's not really boxing in my opinion.
Mm. So by the end of our training session today, I need to be able to survive a round with a professional boxer. Do you think it can be done?
No.
No, fair enough. Fortunately, I'm in prime physical condition, as you can see.
Yes.
So a lot of the hard work's already done. What do you think we need to do today to add the finishing touches?
A little bit of maybe fitness, work on the basics. It's just enough for you to survive, really. If that's what you want to do, survive 2 minutes in the ring. So.
All right, well, that's enough chatting. It's time to get whacking. I think one of the big flaws of this plan was that we only gave ourselves an hour to do it, and because Keith said he can't do it any longer, but I don't really know what he's doing over there.
As I was taking on board Keith's lessons, I couldn't help but feel like something was missing.
Right, so I think I've got the boxing part down, but if I'm going to be big in this sport, as we know, the biggest guys are all entertainers. So you've got Tyson Fury, you've got Nassim Hamid, you've got Floyd Mayweather, and they do like a little bit of showboating and that kind of stuff in the ring to throw them off. So what would you think if in the middle of the ring, just do a little bit of that, a little bit of that?
Yeah, that might go. You could probably add some clown shorts or something, some clown shoes.
So you don't think that's going to work?
Yeah,
do you reckon you could teach me how to do the Naz flip into the ring?
If I want to break my back, I probably could, yes.
Okay. And then what about a little bit of trash talking?
Well, you do that anyway.
You do a little bit of trash talking.
I've gathered, yeah. A little trash talking, yeah. You always got to big the fight up, yeah. So
yeah.
Trash talking, nothing wrong with that.
So you think I'm ready then?
Oh, I think you're ready, yeah.
All right, perfect. Let's get to the ring.
It was clear Keith had been in the game too long to appreciate modern techniques, but nonetheless, the time had now come for me to face the music and step in with a professional boxer. Although, similarly to the trainer situation, finding a professional boxer who was willing to come to Bracknell on a Thursday morning proved more difficult than expected. So once again, we're turning to Keith.
Hi, I'm Keith.
There's been a lot of build-up to this contest. We know the fans are excited, and so are we, so let's meet the fighters. In the red corner we have myself, a complete novice and Boxing Index founder, Cameron Prithyboy Temple, with a nickname that fits the face. And before we get comments saying anything otherwise, the camera adds 10 pounds, so that's what that is. I'm 23 years old, 5'10", my weight is undisclosed, so I'm still carrying a little bit of holiday weight and would rather not say. I have an amateur record of 0-0 and an identical professional record of 0-0, otherwise known as undefeated. In the blue corner we have Keith the Keith Mana, who is 60 years old, 5'8", he weighs in at 11 stone 10 ounces. He has an amateur record of 48 wins, 9 losses, and a professional record of 8 wins and 1 loss. He was the number 9 ranked amateur in this country in the light welterweight division in 1991, and the 9th ranked professional in 1994. He also won the Southern Area title, so basically I have no business being in there with him, but let's see what happens. So without further ado, let's get into the action. There's the opening bell and away we go for the most highly anticipated fight of the year. You can just feel the tension in the crowd. We like a little bit of showboating there, implementing what we learnt in training. Both moving well, nothing to really separate the fighters yet. Oh, backed up into a corner already. Not the best, but see, I think what was going on in my head was that I was thinking, I'll let him beat me up a little bit, lure him into a full sense of security, and then just, you know, launch the haymakers and he'll end up in some real trouble. Haven't quite found the range with the jab there yet, and back in the corner again. But as I said, it's all part of the plan. It's actually kind of embarrassing for me, but you know, I'm going to just pretend this isn't happening, and instead just take the time to tell you about the new subscription service we have on the Boxing Index, because that'll be slightly less painful for me to think about than watching myself just get beat up. So here at the Boxing Index, we aim to create the most entertaining and thought-provoking boxing content on the internet. For your first month, you can become a Boxing Index supporter and unlock our daily stream of exclusive articles, interviews, and betting tips for free. And after that, it's only $2.99 a month, and you can cancel if you don't like it. Alternatively, you can become a Boxing Index super supporter, meaning you'll also have access to all our exclusive content, as well as the opportunity to take part in weekly writer Q&As, be entered into giveaways, and you'll be contributing £1 of your subscription to the Boxing Index Fund, where all proceeds will be made available to financially support boxing gyms and small hall boxers, and that's excluding the free promotional period, and that's only $4.99 a month. So I'll take you back to the commentary now. I think about 6-7 left hooks in a row there to the face. Looking at the clock there, I'm thinking, I don't know how much of this Keith can take. And it's all over, waved off there by me, also in a referee capacity as well as a boxer. I think any sane human being would have to score that one a draw. There was absolutely nothing to separate the two fighters. Good show of respect there at the end. I think we'll go to the fighters to see if they've got any last comments.
So I'm not sure if we came here to achieve the aim that we came for, but I've definitely learned a few things. I've learned that my fitness needs work. I was gone about 1 minute 45 seconds into that round. I think if it only went 10 seconds, I think I was winning that round. I think every pundit would say that. But the most important thing we've learned is that nobody hits as hard as life. It's not about how hard you get hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep on moving forward.
Shut up?